All right, man. New update is coming. I'm not gonna be as energetic today because I'm kind of tired. So let's go ahead and get to it, man. We're gonna start off with what they're saying inside the Discord in terms of what's coming up inside the new update. So starting off with what Red Snow said right here, it says, get ready. On the court, power forward Elise showcases remarkable prowess. His shooting skills are exceptional, with each shot executed with pinpoint accuracy. In critical moments of the game, it can also read the play and deliver precise assists, becoming a reliable pillar for his teammates. Elise is not only a game changer on the court, but also a formidable presence that opponents fear. Its presence redefines intelligence and strategy in sports competition. So on the court, Elise has demonstrated an astounding passing ability, with its pass and distribute skill being particularly noteworthy. It can assess the positions of teammates and the opponent's defense, delivering the ball with high precision directly to nearby teammates. Moreover, as the number of consecutive successful passes increases, this probability also rises, making it a crucial weapon in the team's offense. So this looks like a flick pass. That's definitely what it is. She's definitely flicking the ball right there to her teammates. That's definitely going to come in handy, man, because if she wins the flick, she can flick it directly to her dunker or her inside scorer like Albert or May. Or even someone like Zachary Pinky, their dunkers, and I said that already. But yeah, man, flick pass looks really nice. And I'm not sure if they mean just successfully doing regular passes or successfully getting the flick pass to activate that'll increase the probability of this activating. But I guess we'll see when we get there. I'm pretty sure it's just going to be from the flick passes, though. So we're just going to say the more flick passes you get to activate, the more often it's going to activate. So you want to make sure you're using flicks. Flick was already a really good ability on power forwards and centers. But with the addition of a flick pass on Elise, it's definitely going to make a difference. So moving on to engine acceleration. Through the engine acceleration skill, Elise can consume energy to sprint, enhancing its off-ball movement speed. Multiple boosts can trigger overheat, allowing it to reach an unparalleled speed for a short period, making it unstoppable. So it looks like she's dashing towards the rim. It looks more so like a no-ball sprint. Towards the rim, and they said that it has stamina attached to it, so I'm not sure if you can sprint for longer than they're showing inside this animation right here. Don't ask me, not completely sure, but it looked like it's a really good ability for getting her to the inside, and she also has access to a lightning dunk. So if she does that sprint closer to the rim, you pass to her, next thing you know, she's getting that lightning dunk off with no one to contest her. That's what people were doing with Zachary at first, not with lightning dunk though. They had to do it with the skillful screen. They had to use a skillful screen dash, and it's like a millisecond difference in terms of the sprint when you look at these two animations, because you have to do the screen animation and then sprint. You don't have to hold it as long as people who don't have skillful screen, but this right here, definitely going to be a better ability for getting yourself to the rim before the bigs get there. So next we're looking at the quick grab and block SP. I'm pretty sure this is just the same thing as Alto's quick grab and block. Let's read it. The quick grab and block SP skill significantly enhances Elise's shot blocking ability. It not only speeds up its reaction time for blocks, but also grants a chance to snatch the ball directly during a shot attempt, making it an insurmountable defensive barrier for opponents. So she's going to be good on both sides of the ball, man. We got yet another two-way player. They're saying shots inside of her description, but it's very obvious that she's going to be dunk based. So let's go ahead and read this outro for her. Can't wait to witness the mechanical marvel shine on the court. This showdown will be the ultimate clash between human ingenuity and mechanical precision, a direct confrontation of natural prowess and futuristic technology. Will human players dominate with their instincts and skills? Or will the robot rise to the occasion with precise calculations and relentless optimization? Are we all ready to embrace this unprecedented challenge? Let's stay tuned and see. So yeah, man, pretty good communication from them. We see what we're getting before it gets here. Before we spend all of our rubies trying to unlock this character, we have access to what she's going to be doing, what she's going to be looking like, so on and so forth. So next, we're looking at the new skins. So War has changed. Like a phantom in the night, Andrew embodies the top gun of the Patriots, and his tactical genius is unmatched. He is the snake in the shadows, the master of stealth and assassination, leading his prey unknowingly into the jaws of death. Embrace the true legend, this son of liberty, and step into the shadows with our new skin, the Stalker. That's a pretty nice skin, man. They got a snake skin for Andrew now. Well, they say Elise's rare skin, Crimson Blade. Elise's rare skin, Crimson Blade, will be launched simultaneously. Plus, several spine-chilling Halloween exclusive skins are waiting for you to unlock. So, new costume, flame pumpkin set. Autumn is the perfect season for eating pumpkins, but these pumpkins won't let you eat them without a fight. The flame pumpkin set, exuding a terrifying aura, warns everyone with its evil expression. Not so easy to bully. The unique design perfectly blends the roundness of the pumpkin with the intensity of the flames, making it unforgettable at first sight. I looked at this earlier, and I'm just now remembering what it looks like. So that's Cap Raccoon Digi. Super Captain set features a sturdy shield on his back and a gleaming belt around his waist, symbolizing the power of justice. The meticulous design highlights both speed and strength, as if always ready to charge into battle. Wearing a red military cap, he exudes a commanding presence, embodying the iconic hero who protects the city. Captain America? Is this like a Captain America set or something? I don't know, man. I don't think he wears that type of hat. So, Undying Swordsman set. Behind the iconic chilling mask lies a Devil May Care grin, a blend of razor-sharp dual blades and golden twin pistols, exuding an attitude of maximum effort. This set is designed for those who walk the fine line between chaos and control, ready to strike fear into the hearts of their enemies. These outfits will be available through upcoming events. And it says, stay tuned. They're not going to be ready immediately, I'm guessing. So, in terms of the Discord stuff, that's what we got so far. So let's go ahead and jump to this notice and take a look at the balance changes. Balance adjustments adjusted the opening jump ball trajectory so the ball cannot be split during its ascent. So you may have already noticed this happening, but characters like Emma, Robbie, Daisuke, Alan, they could all hit the ball before it reached its dropping point. But now that is no longer a thing. Jump ball is now more skill based than it is character based. So make sure y'all keep that in mind, man. You're going to have to learn what the new timing is for you to hit it as soon as possible, because you cannot hit the ball before it starts to descend anymore. So sniper attribute cannot trigger effects when using 3-point skills. That's going to count for the pull up. That's going to count for the fadeaway three. That's going to count for the drift three. That's going to count for the turnaround shot that Black Crow has. Basically, any ability outside the 3-point line, it will now trigger sniper. So people were wondering why that wasn't a thing before, but looks like it was just a bug and it just got fixed. So assassin attribute can now trigger effects when using close shot or layup skills. I'm pretty sure it was already doing that, because I seen Sarah proc an assassin. I seen Silverwolf proc an assassin. So that was already a thing, but I guess they just went ahead and let us know that that was a possibility. So skill, alley-oop 3, base hit rate reduced to 10%, and interference resistance effect changed to increase open shot hit rate. So you only have, I don't know what the base hit rate is now, because when they showed us the nerf to the block avoiding, they showed us that it was 95% accuracy, and then it got reduced to 75% accuracy. So we don't know what the accuracy is. We just know that it's 10 less than it was before. We're just gonna assume it was 100, and we're gonna say that it's 90 now. So interference resistance effect changed to increase open shot hit rate. Yes, I looked at all of that already. So all of the disturbance resistance, which was 15%, was changed to open shot hit rate, and it's still 15%, I'm sure. So skill, toss dunk, confrontation increased, changed to reduce block probability. So instead of you getting extra strength, it's gonna give you block resistance, and that's I'm not sure if that's gonna make much of a difference. I'm not sure how big of a difference it is between confrontation and block resistance, but we will certainly see. I'm pretty sure that now that you don't get the extra strength, it won't be as easy to power through. So next we're looking at Nico. I don't know how to pronounce his name, man. It's just so many different ways. The pull-up fadeaway, shot speed increased, and shot height increased. So this is probably gonna make him a little bit stronger than he should be, because we're seeing the same issue with Rika. They buffed the small forward shot height, and then they buffed her shot height and her shot speed in the exact same update. So she basically got double buffed in terms of shot height, and she's just so hard to stop these days. I mean, if you don't jump super early, or if you're not like right there on her when she does her jump stop shot, and you don't have a really high block height, gonna be very difficult to block that. You're gonna need like a power forward, small forward, or a center to block it consistently. So moving on to the level fours, Mary gets a level 4 flash shot, and it's the same thing as Mo Chen, and it's the same thing as Maggie. You just get a 25% chance to ignore interference. Butterball, he's getting a level 4 jump stop shot, and it's the same thing as David, same thing as Amanda, same thing as Rika. He's just getting the extra 10% disturbance resistance. Will that make a difference? Yes, That certainly makes a difference, because before the Ace update came out, Butterball only had 7% disturbance resistance. And then when the Ace update came out, if you get Ace Butterball, you get 5% more from the small forward affix for a total of 12. And then he's getting this 10% right here to go with that. So we're looking at 22% disturbance resistance on a jump stop shot from Butterball now. And yes, it makes a world of a difference. So yeah, man, this is the new update, new character. Very interesting. A few months ago, I told y'all that we were moving more and more towards a speed and mobility meta. And you can see that manifesting right now. Most of the characters being used are speed based. Most of the characters being used have some type of off ball ability or things like a smart layup where they can skip the walk to the rim and just get on in there and do what they got to do to either score or get their teammates scoring opportunities. And now we have this new character coming in with an off ball sprint, and it looks like it's really nice. It's much better than having a skillful screen and wasting that half a second that you need to get to the rim before the center or power forward comes in there to contest. The flick pass looks really nice. I'm pretty sure that's going to help in a lot of situations, because if you have a center and a power forward on your team, most of the time one is going to be boxing out and the other is going to be going for the rebound, and she can just flick pass to her teammates if you are boxing her out. So yeah, man, interesting update. Hyped to see what this new character is going to be playing like, especially inside higher elo, because you know how they are with their dunks, bro. They love those lightning dunks. They love any dunk variation, if we're being honest. And it's not very often that we get a dunker that has this level of mobility, that has this level of defense. So, all right, man, we're going to wrap this video up. Y'all want to see more of this? Go ahead and drop a like, sub to the channel, and I'll catch y'all next one, man.